In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your Spirit and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in His consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to you, O Lord.
O Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
O Lord.
When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Jesus answered them and said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him, the Father, God has set his seal." So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent." So they said to him, "What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written. He gave them bread from heaven to eat." So Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." So they said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Tita Lynn.
3 pointers for today's Gospel. Number one, in today's Gospel, Jesus told the crowd that they sought him simply for food for their body instead of working for food that feeds them for all eternity. Number two, we are all called to serve God wholeheartedly. And this is possible only if our belief in him is deep and strong. How much of your time is given to God? Number three, only God can satisfy the deepest longing of our hearts. How true is this in your life? Have you experienced any fulfillment in life that is deeper than what God can give you? This would certainly not be possible. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Tita Lynn. So today's gospel, today's gospel is about the bread, no? I am the bread of life, sabi nga ni Jesus, no? So we can ponder on the topic about your hunger, our own hunger. Do we hunger for the bread, bread na dito sa atin bread, or the spiritual bread? So the material bread, or the physical bread, or the bread that world, no, that the world is giving to us, no, also includes the worldly possessions, power, money, you know, all those things, influence, mga ganyan. Pero the bread that is the spiritual bread that Jesus is offering, no, na he is the bread of life, no, the spiritual bread includes, you know, love thy neighbor, compassion, forgiveness, and the like. So we are all feel hungry, either the material bread or the bread of life. So the choice is ours. So Jesus is offering the bread that is the living bread, that is His bread. So modern times natin, nandiyan lang siya. He's just there in the Holy Eucharist. He's there. He's and it's free. If we are hungry for the spiritual bread, no, Jesus is always available for no price. For no price, just go to Mass. He is there. He is waiting for us. We are always invited to His banquet. Yun. As sinful as we are, as sinner as we are, imagine, no? He is inviting us to His banquet. So it's up for us, no? It's up for us to accept the invitation. He is giving away for free the bread of life. So are we going to reject it? Before this Zoom meeting, we are talking, me and Tita Linda was talking about going to Mass, receiving Holy Communion, na Tita Linda, I salute you, no, na come what may, ano tawag dito, yung bad weather or good weather, talagang nagasimba si Tita Lynn every single day because she feels hungry if she cannot receive the Holy Eucharist. Ganyan din ang ano natin. Oh, ganyan din. I know some of us here are, you know, we receive the bread of life every day. And if we cannot, sometimes if we are used to that, na isang, just like Tita Bell, no? I know Tita Bell also is always hungry for the bread of life. Na kung ma-miss natin, no? Kung ma-miss natin, parang hungry na hungry tayo. Thirsty na thirsty tayo. So, what a beautiful, deep relationship with Jesus. If we just listen to Him and accept Him, accept His offer, accept His invitation to attend or to join Him in His banquet. Amen.
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 Do you have something from Father Tito Bell?
Inday Irene muna or ako na? Inday Irene muna.
Please unmute yourself, Yan.
For the gospel, so this actually is emphasizing the insignificance and importance of the Holy Eucharist. I can recall that the phrase or even the that I learned before, what you want to be is, or what you eat is what you want to be. So if you eat the body of Christ daily, then we will become like Jesus, which should, how great would that be if we will be like Jesus? So that's why we are encouraged to attend Mass. And just tell me as much as possible, I really want to attend Mass. Attending Mass, even if it's early in the morning, it's really different, especially when we are done with confession and then we do communion. It's really a different feeling wherein you can really feel the presence of the Lord, and you can really I can sense the conversion or that feeling of light is really different. So just the bread alone, when you receive the Holy Communion, I also wanted to share to you what just happened this morning also. Usually Saturday and Sunday, if I'm not on duty, I go with my papa, who always attend the Dawn Rosary. So after the Dawn Rosary, there's a Holy Mass, the first Mass of the day. So that happens every Saturday and Sunday. Just this morning, when I attended with him when the rosary ended, and then as we walked into the aisle, it's actually in the Santa Rosaria Church, so there's a big cross, and then it's the Holy Spirit and the Father in front. So it's just that it's a different feeling, because when I saw the God the Father, just my I just out of nowhere, I just had tears. And I just asked, Lord, what is this that you want to tell me? It's just that I am reminded that I will be in on leave this week, and then the more time that I can spend with him. So that moment, it's just a very good feeling that there's some communication. I know there's more time and reflect more. Being in that moment inside the church, and then more thinking of more time with the Lord. It's such a great feeling to have that one. And that's something that I really wanted to look forward to for this week, as I am having my leave. That's all. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, thank you, Day Irene. Deeper relation. Yeah, deeper relation with Jesus. Tita Bel?
Father Tito, touch on 3 points. And the first point that he touched on, because the entire month of August, it's all about the discourse on the bread of life. And number one, he pointed out that in the context on the aspect of the pandemic gave us a renewed sense of spirituality. And that's how we feel also. The Mass, the returning to the Mass, the Rosary, our Bible recollection, and the sense of community. That's what we really felt in our Zoom prayer meeting and our Rosary time, right? Then there's the continued devotion to the Mass because of its availability, because it's being Zoom, no? And then he asked, number two, the question is, where are we now? Where are we now? We still continue with our daily Zoom prayer meeting, our daily Zoom Mass, but we try as much to go to the church in order for us to feel or to receive the Eucharist, right? Because for us, we feel that after the pandemic, we are not contented anymore with the Zoom Mass. Me, in my experience, I go to Mass with Father Tito every 5 o'clock or 5:30 in the morning, because it's only 30 minutes. But I try as much really to go to church in the afternoon so that I can receive the communion, because I also feel incomplete without the Eucharist. So that's what Father Tito said. Where are we now? Are we still having the renewed sense of spirituality, renewed sense of affection for the Holy Eucharist, for the daily Mass, our rosaries? Yes, we are. No, I will just look at our prayer group. We feel so incomplete if we're absent. We feel parang disloyal, mag-guilty ka kung hindi ka maka-attend sa Zoom prayer meeting. That's why our CEO said, oh, where are you going? I'm going up, but I did not say that I'm going to attend my Zoom. I just said, I will go up because I'm way past my bedtime. Pero para naman akong I don't know. I don't
para
want to
ma-redeem.
Let them know. Oh, I'm going up because of my Zoom prayer meeting. So I just let them. No, I will go up na to my room. So that's how I feel na. Para kang incomplete na hindi ka maka-attend sa Zoom prayer meeting.
Yeah, it's true.
So, and that's what Father Tito said, that we should seek for greater things. Not just the physical bread, but rather the bread of life, no? Because during the pandemic, we were so uncertain, we're so vulnerable those times. But we opened our hearts, our minds, our lives to the Spirit of God's grace, no? And that's what Father Tito really always emphasized, that we should open our hearts to God's grace, because we only have to ask for God's grace and it will be given to us. Not that the Lord will force us to accept His grace, but we have to open our hearts. We have to really ask for God's grace. The number three is, we will understand more and more our devotion to the Mass, to live out the grace to which the sacraments, like the sacrament of reconciliation, no? We ask for God's mercy to forgive our sins, and we also ask for the grace to forgive those who wronged us, and ask for the grace also for the reconciliation with the people to whom we have wronged. No? So to live out in the day-to-day our discipleship as disciples of Christ. So hopefully we renew our devotion to the Mass, continue living it out in our day-to-day, especially the receiving of the Holy Eucharist. So I can understand how Tita Linda feels. Yeah. She even receives the Holy Communion 2 or 3 times a day. She goes to Mass 2 or 3 times a day and receive the Holy Communion 2 or 3 times a day.
Oh.
See how that's the hunger that you will feel. No? Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Bell. No. Beautiful feeling, no? Beautiful feeling. Yeah. So, really. So I think we can have our sharing regarding how do you feel? Where are you now? Where are you now after the trials, no? Whatever trials in life now we have, or maybe the most common is during the pandemic, no? We became so religious, we became so prayerful. We always attend, if not every day, pero always attend the online Mass, no, during the pandemic. So, where are we now? 'Yun ang question. Saan na tayo ngayon after those trials? And after the trials, after the pandemic, yun ang ano, yun ang example, yun ang example ni Father Tito, or maybe your personal trial. Oh, where are you now?
Persevering, no? That's our persevering in our faith, in our discipleship, in our love for God, that we really continue in spite the fact that we already have passed the pandemic, but we still hunger for His word, we still hunger for the Eucharist, and I think that's what Father Danny meant, to love Him more and more each day. Amen.
Oh, thank you, Belle.
First na sharing ko. I was heard just a first sharing. Hello? Okay.
Please go ahead.
Just like what I said a while ago with regards to the Holy Eucharist. So, that's how we would intend to want ourselves to be like Jesus if we continue to take the Holy Communion. And I also learned when taking the Holy Communion, it would be best also to have confession. What I learned is actually a monthly confession, or the more frequent we do the confession, the better. In order for us to really absorb. Kasi there is also what I learned that it's also not good to take the Holy Communion if we feel something bad, or we are in a situation that we are not in, or in hatred, or we are, how do I call this one? So dapat, it's what I learned is dapat we are at peace, or we are ready when we receive the Holy Communion, when we receive Jesus through the Holy Communion. It should be a preparation that we're in. We are emptying ourselves, and then we are opening our hearts fully. So no dark or anything that that is not good, because it will just worsen. It will not make us more at peace, rather. Or and that's how I learned also with regards to the Holy Eucharist. And then I think my sister Karen has something to share also.
Karen, share. My sister mentioned regarding the Holy Eucharist. So I'd just like to share with you a personal experience I had before. This is about.
Please go ahead.
Maklaro na dito, no? You know.
Please go ahead.
Okay. I'd just like to share with you. My sister Irene mentioned regarding the Holy Eucharist, with regards to being prepared before taking Jesus. So I had an experience before, several years ago. This is about asking God for the grace before taking the Holy Communion. There was one time ang good nga, I had a friend nga naglagot kay ko. I was really mad at him. So what happened was, just few minutes before the Holy Communion, because I wanted to empty my, I wanted to make, to be at, I mean, I wanted to feel at peace at that time. I decided to ask the Lord, "Lord, I'm so mad at my friend, but then I don't want to receive you with this kind of disposition." So what I did was I asked the Lord, "Lord, please grant, I decide to forgive my friend, and I decide to receive you with a peaceful heart, Lord. So please grant me the grace." I just said that. And then even before I finished asking God for that grace, I immediately felt peace in my heart. So though it was just a simple prayer, but the Lord had seen my desire to be at peace. So I would say, Nona, the Lord really listens to your heart. The Lord really listens to your intention. So I was so happy at that time, because I was able to receive Jesus with so much peace in my heart. And after it was really funny, because when I was about to go back to my seat, I saw my friend, he arrived so late. And instead of getting mad at him, what happened was I just smiled at him as if nothing happened. So it was really a grace from the Lord, no? It was really a wonderful grace God has given me at that time. So, it's really good that we should be in a proper disposition when we receive Jesus, because I will never forget what Mama told us, that we have to, as much as possible, we have to empty our hearts from all negativities before Jesus, before receiving Jesus in the Holy Communion. So, and I praise the Lord for that wonderful experience.
Amen. Amen. May i-ask sana ako kay Day Karen. Is that your boyfriend na you were so mad
the
with?
Same question in my mind. My ex. Yeah, my ex is
oh, the one who hurts your feeling. The one who has hurt
yeah.
your feeling.
I'll try forgiveness.
Forgiveness, yan. Instant
yes.
healing.
Yes,
your instant healing. Oh, thank you, Day Irene. Oh, Karen.
You're welcome, Tita.
Tito Manch, you have something? Or anybody who wants to share about how you feel about Holy Eucharist? Or were you transformed after the trials in life? Were you transformed? Did you crave more, or have you craved more the bread of life? Anybody? Please go ahead.
During the time nung struggling pa ako the separation from my husband, and I was separated from my eldest son as well because he brought my eldest son with him, and so I was really struggling then between emotions, spiritual and physical as well, because I was sickly then. And thank God, after my separation, I was I was adopted by a community, the Jesucristi community. I was adopted by them. So I became one of their students at that time. And they were all providing me guidance and advices on what to do. And after that, I was hungry for him, for God, because of my affiliation with the community. I was attending masses daily. And I guess from there, God was really, at that time, was really carrying me, I guess. And I feel so, that he was really carrying me, because at that time, thinking about my eldest son away from me, I was really devastated. Even though I still have my two children, I really felt devastated, because I don't want him to grow up in the surrounding of my or influence of my in-laws. Thankfully, my eldest son is now with me, and I just entrusted him. At that time, I just entrusted him to Mama Mary. I always say, Mama Mary, please take care of my son for me. And I praise and thank God. Everything, I was able to hurdle the hardest point of my life. And now I'm happy that the children, I was able to bring them up, although nag-backslide ang mga boys, but then I'm happy that they were serving the church, and that was it. That's all. I'm just happy that after the trials in my life, I was really... I mean, I hunger more to be near Jesus. And even now, I really thank Doc Bell because I became a part of this community and prayer community or prayer group, and like I was praying before that I wanted to join or to be a lector at the Basilica, but then my son never asked his friend there what are the requirements, so I never had the chance to be a lector, and I wish to be a lector naman sa among parish. Unfortunately, I didn't have the courage to go to the parish and the office, and then came Doc Bell inviting me to join the community or the prayer group, and I guess this is where the Lord wants me to be.
You know, Sal, I want to also to be a lector. That's why I'm smiling, because pareho pala tayo. I really want to be a lector. That's my dream that I haven't realized.
Destined to be in the prayer warriors.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Tita Sal. Beautiful experience, beautiful feeling. And the bread of life is your healing.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Since I became a widow for 37 years already, Tita, I always pray and offer everything to God. I'm so very thankful also that I have overcome all those trials in my life because of the strong family support. And if I cannot go to church during Sunday because I am alone and somebody who is helping us it's also her off day, so I have to request my daughter to turn on the TV to have a online mass. So if I have the chance to go to church weekdays, I have really to receive communion because it is the only moment that I can say that my heart is so light if I could receive our Lord Jesus Christ. And it makes me strong. My heart is always light if I say, Lord, please forgive me and be my guide always, because I am a single parent and I have the experienced many trials and also God is always there. He is always there to listen, and thanks God, my prayers were answered. And now I still continue to serve Him as much as I have to do in my life. Amen.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Wow. Thank you very much. Beautiful experience, no? Personal. Your personal relationship with God, with Jesus.
To me, it is a mission.
Huh?
You see, it is a mission. I became a Eucharistic minister in 1985, if I'm correct, 1985. I was in my early 40s. 1985 up to, it was only abruptly stopped because of the pandemic. After that, I decided to continue, but I have to ask the permission at the palace prison because I was already over the age limit. Age limit is 75. So I have to ask his permission of the palace priest. Because of that commitment. It is a commitment. See? Just, it is not a job. It's not a work. It is a commitment. That's why you if you are given that mission, you have to do it. No? And you need God's grace to do it. Imagine you have to wake up a certain time every day. And it is really a sacrifice, no? Anyone who has a mission and is committed to the mission, he will feel that it is a sacrifice. And up to when, only God knows. As long as I can have the strength to do it, given that strength, I can still continue. Because I have to, it is really a commitment. Imagine waking up early. Because the one I'm giving communion now is a member or an official of the Opus Dei. The norm of the Opus Dei is a daily reception of communion, daily mass, and frequent confession, at least monthly confession. And he gave me some instructions about being a member of an Opus Dei. And it's not easy, really. Every fourth Sunday of the month, there is a monthly mass. You have to attend the monthly mass. Medyo malayo siya. Our place, no, it's in Alabang. No? We are here in Supat, Aspinias, Alabang, medyo, it's a little far. We are medyo time constraints and still have to do some work in the house also. Kaya medyo talagang sacrifice yan, sacrifice. And God will give you that strength, that courage, that inspiration to go on, hold on. And with this prayer group gives me a chance to be involved in a deep prayer. Thank you. and about the Eucharist. Yeah, Eucharist. Going to Mass daily is really a big sacrifice also. But that is the only way that you can be able to have a strong relationship with God through prayers, this prayer group, through prayers. And I've read the reflection of Marino das Marinhas about that saint, Saint Catherine of Siena, I think.
Catherine of
Siena. She was sick, no, sickly. And her only sustenance, because I think she cannot eat solid food, I think. And her only sustenance is the Eucharist. And she survived many years because of the Eucharist. Imagine, Eucharist lang. Huh? She survived. And she became a saint. And all of us have that possibility of becoming one through the Eucharist. And more importantly, we have to pray for our priests, without the priest, there's no Eucharist. No priest, no Eucharist. So we have to pray for them also. That's what we are doing. Pray for your priest. I may have some health issues, but God's grace and inspiration, strength keeps me going. And Eucharist, the Eucharist gives you that strength. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you very much, Tito Mans. So I think that that ends our gospel and reflection for today. And the bread of life is, you know, we have a choice whether the bread of the world or bread of life. As our closing prayer, all together, let's pray the spiritual communion. All together, please. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself to you. Never permit me to separate from you. Amen. And all together, please, glory be to the Father, glory to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Spirit,
and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. Bye. Love you guys.
Thank you. God love.
Bye.